Welcome to all of you. Today we discuss on the root crop harvesting equipment. You know the classification of the root crop harvesting equipment according to the sources of power, manual operated, hand tools, digging aids such as the spade, khurpa, digging, picking, fork, etc. Animal drawn equipment such as a potato plow, animal drawn groundnut digger, etc. Now the tractor operated equipment such as a spinner digger, elevator digger, groundnut digger, shaker windrower, sugar beet harvester, carrot harvester, radish harvester, etc. Now the self-propelled machine such as a potato harvester, combine, groundnut, combine, sugar beet harvester. According to the mode of hitching, trail type, mounted type, a semi-mounted type and self-propelled type. Now, the according to the unit operation performed is classified as a simple digger, digger shaker, digger elevator, digger shaker conveyor, and digger shaker winter. According to the completion of the operation, the direct harvest equipment which accomplish the complete operation of digging, separating to the soil, as well as the collecting the recoverable product in one go. In direct harvesting machine, it is that the equipment which accomplish the complete operation in more than one passes. For instance, our groundnut digger shaker windrower digs the beans, deposit them in a windrower after shaking of the soil, and the beans are sun-dried for a few days, and thereafter a groundnut combined with pickup. Consideration for the proper field operation of the root crop harvesting equipment. The following are the sum of the general consideration: proper field layout, proper planting method, proper moisture content at the harvest time, pre-harvest treatment such as the holm cutting, vine killing, proper adjustment of the depth of the digging, and proper hitching of the machine, proper adjustment of the speed of the picking, conveying and shaking system. And selection of the desired forward speed in keeping with the field and crop condition. Numbers of worker in a crew to pick the collected material simultaneously and matching the transport handling equipment to the capacity of the digger and harvester. Now, what are the general consideration of the root crop harvesting equipment, variety of the crop and culture practices? In case existing variety and cultural practices pose some problems in mechanical harvesting, an attempt should be made to make the necessary modification. The second is the soil type. The soil type and moisture content at the time of the harvesting are important factors influencing the machine performance. Therefore, suitable soil amending substance may help to develop the proper soil texture to eliminate the problem of excessive blade clogging and clod formation. The soil for root crops should be friable for easy separation. Third is the method of irrigation. One must carefully consider the method of irrigation being followed depending upon where the crop is sown on ridges, bed, flat surface. Proper method of the irrigation should be selected and the availability of the right moisture content at the time of harvesting is very essential for proper penetration of the blade. Now, machine design consideration, the type of digging shovel, shape and size, and conveying the separation system, it must be efficient to handle and separate the loose material with minimum injuries. The height of fall, avoid the excessive height of the fall of the roots, tuber to lessen injuries. If the required, use inside the rubber padding at the component to minimize the external and internal injury. Proper speed, the speed of the component used for the translocation and separation of the material should be such that this do not lead to excessive agitation, damage and loss of the product. Control is also the various control for raising and lowering of the blade varying speed should be carefully designed. Provision should be made for adjusting the speed of the component. Use the multi-speed gearbox and varying the drives is desirable on root crop harvesting machine. Now, operational design consideration. The design requirement of the root crop harvesting equipment should be
Digger should be cut when below the tuber, say at the depth of 7 to 10 centimeter. Lift all vines, shake off the soil and put them in the windrow in a single operation. And another, the desired penetration of the blade should be possible at the working moisture content of the soil. And the digger should work with the seasonable overall efficiency for both erect and spreading the varieties. And pod detachment losses for existing the varieties should be reasonable low, and it should be possible with the tractor of 30 HP or more. Then types of blade are also again the use in the digger. Half sweep type blades are sometimes not used as the flow of the material is not smooth and some undug plant are also left. The single piece curve blade is commonly used in a digger. Now, adjustment of the method of working, and before working up the machine, necessary adjustment should be made. Normally, depth of working is 7.5 to 12.5 cm or 4 cm below the pod zone is adequate. Increase the load on shaker and forward speed of the tractor should be 2 to 3 km per hour. This is a potato digger. Potato digger elevator consists of the shovel, rod, chain, conveyor, gearbox or two gauge wheels. This is a tractor operated single row potato digger elevator. This is isometric view of the groundnut digger shaker. You can see the digging blade, coulters, frames, V-belt, conveyor and sprocket wheel. This is groundnut digger shaker. This is also the tractor operated groundnut blades or diggers, groundnut digging. You can see the upper diagram and lower diagram also. Thank you very much.